I should be writing number 472, January 9th, 2020.
Well, I should be writing. I should be working on my craft. I should be writing. I should be submitting my next draft. But I'm sitting watching Doctor.
Hi there, welcome to I Should Be Writing, the podcast for wannabe fiction writers. I'm your host, Myra Lafferty. And I talked about this a little bit before the break, but I've been thinking about it a lot more. And that's how much credit we don't give our subconscious. And I was thinking today that's like, if you got up and thought, I'm going to need to remember to breathe thousands of times today, you might panic. Because we all know we get distracted and don't remember to do things. I'm feeling a little short of breath right now trying to think, okay, I got to breathe now. But we don't get up and think, I'm going to need to remember to breathe thousands of times today, because you trust your involuntary muscles to do that. You don't have to tell your heart to beat. And granted, these are instinctual things that, involuntary things that happen. But along the same lines, a lot of times it's good to step back from your work and think, I need to puzzle through this plot point. But on the other hand, there's some things that can only be worked through in the middle of work, in the middle of writing. And this may be a pantser thing. I come up with my best ideas in the middle of writing. I'll come up with the concept of a story, but it doesn't start to actually get interesting until I start writing it down. And I was panicking about editing the story, and then I just realized once I sat down and started going through the edits and picking up the little things, like a misspelling here and a character's name change there, I could also catch deeper things in the text. With editing, it's even harder because you definitely can't, in a lot of cases, step away and think, how am I going to fix this? You have to actually be looking at the text, unless it's a deeper plot point. But I'm saying, even if you don't consciously know how you're going to fix something or how a scene's going to go, don't spend too much time away from the work. It's all a balance. That's the irritating thing about writing and writing advice, is that everything's balanced. Do you want to write something without researching at all? Of course not. You'll either sound like you don't know what you're talking about, or you'll a big fat liar. But can you get mired in research for weeks and never write a word? Yes, that can happen too. So you have to find the happy medium between do enough research to write the thing, but don't get lost down the rabbit hole. Along the same lines, sometimes it's best if you're stuck to step away from the work. But you also have to trust your subconscious, your involuntary breathing muscles, as it were, that when you sit down to write, you got to give it a little bit of a push, but things will kick in. And you'll find it easier than you thought it would be when you were standing 10 feet away from your computer going, oh God, what am I going to do? And that's something that you got to be careful about, hitting that happy medium. It's like athletes. Can they think too much and psych themselves out of performing well? Yes, definitely. Happens all the time. But if they don't prepare at all and just hope that their muscle memory will take over, they don't prepare mentally at all, they might not perform as well. So you need to find that happy medium. But trust in yourself. I've been discovering that teaching my daughter how to drive she has to drive for 60 hours with somebody in the car, a licensed driver in the car with her, before she gets her license. I did not expect it to be so stressful on my end because decades of driving have made a lot of things muscle memory and second nature, and you don't think about it, you just react. While when you're helping someone else drive, you have to vocalize everything. And going from seeing a hazard, knowing what to do, deciding what to do, and then doing it in less than a second, as a seasoned driver will do, vocalizing what to do about that takes a lot longer, and it's really stressful. And I was surprised at how hard it would be for me to, and maintain my calm, because if I got freaked out, she would get freaked out. So having to suddenly talk about all these things that I'd taken for muscle memory and second nature for decades was really challenging. I think that's one reason why not the best people who do things are not necessarily the best teachers, because a lot of people, you know, just do the things. I heard Michael Jordan is a terrible basketball coach because, you know, he tells people do things like I did them. And no one can do what Michael Jordan did. He was Michael Jordan. A lot of times people ask me for specific advice on how to fix a certain thing, and I'm not sure I can answer it because it's something that comes subconsciously to me when I'm deep in the text, the story, the thing. And I feel bad because I've been doing this dang advice podcast for quite some time now, and there's still some things I can't quite tell you how I do. But I'm working on it. Right now, I'm stressed out about an edit, but I realize being stressed out about an edit across the room from my computer is not healthy. It's much better to be engaged with the edit here at the computer. So, now that I'm done recording, I'm going to go engage with that edit right here at the computer. I'm going to trust my subconscious. I'm going to trust, as Stephen King calls it, the people in the basement who are tirelessly working when you're not quite aware of it, and get back to work. So remember, you can support me on Patreon. Patreon.com/MightyMer. You can see the blog and show notes at merverse.com, and you can email me at mightymer@gmail.com. I hope you give your subconscious a chance, because I think it'll perform a little bit better than you expect it to, because you should be writing. Remember, you can support the show at patreon.com/mightymer. I should be writing theme music provided by John Anilio. You can find more about him at johnanilio.com. This podcast is distributed under a Creative Commons Attribution Share Alike license.